Good evening. I was watching the television this evening, and I thought, there's nothing like a good laugh. Good evening. I was watching the television this evening, and I thought, there's nothing like a good laugh.
Sickly.
I was watching the television this evening, and I thought, there's nothing like a good laugh.
Take four.
I was watching the television this evening, and I thought, there's nothing like a good laugh. Oh, religion.
Good evening. And beep, bom, 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 bom. Puzzled? Let me explain. These beep, bom, 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 boms are the latest therapeutic device to alleviate boredom. Beep, bom, 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 bom. People need be never lonely when they've got a pair of beep, bom, 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 boms to play with. Recently, a lady writes, "Sir, my husband died suddenly after being run over by a steamroller, but I have found great comfort in my beep, bom, 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 bom. Pom, 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 pom," signed Mrs. Married people, too, can sit together by the fire and say pim, pom, pom, pom to each other all night long. Real togetherness. Pim, pom, pom, pom. Let's see what fun can be had with a pair of ordinary National Health Service pim, pom, pom, poms and a room full of people.
Pim, pom, pom, pom. Pim, pom, pom, pom. Pim, pom, pom, pom.
Just a minute. These
pim pom pom poms are mine.
Pim pom pom pom.
They fell off while I was shaving.
No.
Pim pom pom pom.
These
pim pom pom pom.
These pim pom pom poms.
Yes.
Are on loan from the British Museum. Pim pom pom pom.
Are you saying that these are early English pim pom pom poms?
No.
Pim pom pom pom.
What? You are.
Are you Jewish?
No, but I can feel a nasty overdraft.
Well, feel those. Just a minute. It's just hello, hello, sailor.
Hello.
Shut up. But just a minute. I think these unpainted hair is pim pom pom pom.
Well done.
And mine. Pim pom pom pom.
Not bad for the first time.
Oh, no, try it.
Right, let me try them. Perhaps they belong to England's biggest landmass, Harry Seagrove.
Pim pom pom pom.
No, he's bigger than this.
Pim pom pom pom.
Oh, pim pom 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 poms are mine.
Impossible.
Excuse me.
Hey.
I have reason to believe that I'm Inspector Scrumpson on the Blin of Scotland Yard, and these pim pom 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 are stolen. I must warn you that any beam bong 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 you say may be taken down.
Stop! You're all wrong! It's John Luthor of Field with Lost for Something fame.
No.
These beam bong 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 bongs are mine. I had them in the bath last night.
Oh, that's why they're damp.
Beam bong bong bong. Beam bong bong. Just a minute. Who are you? Reveal yourself. Mother! Get in, boy.
That seems to go all right. What do you think?
Pim pom 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 pom.
Pim pom 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 pom.
Pim pom 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 pom.
Pom 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 pom.
Pim pom 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 pom.
Darling.
The lady on the bed was Beth Owen, who's done that sort of thing before, only much later in the day and for much less money. There now follows a partly political broadcast on behalf of the Labour Party.
Help!
And now, on behalf of the Conservative Party.
Oh dear, oh dear.
You got to stop doing that. You got to stop that habit.
Ready to go, Ian.
Right.
Right. Okay, Spike.
Ready?
Yes?
Good morning, madam.
Morning.
Good morning.
Madam, madam.
Morning.
I am, I am Herbert Screckle, ace salesman.
Me and my fellow directors would like to know if you are getting sufficient sympathy and understanding in your life.
Not much, why?
Do you mind if we come in, madam?
No.
Supposing you have been out for a hard day shopping, tired out, you get on the tube. Does anybody get up for you?
No fear, not these days. You have to drop bleeding dead.
There's no need for you to drop bleeding dead, madam. Me and my company have invented something for ladies that guarantees to get them a maximum of sympathy and understanding.
What is it? Divorce?
No, madam. It is not the divorce, Tom.
Ow! Christ!
This is the Mark One plastic inflatable sympathy arm. Say you are on a crowded tube.
I'm on a crowded tube.
In a crowded tube. You want to sit down, but no one is getting up for you. Beforehand, you have taken the precaution of placing this bladder up your back so. Now then, all you have to do is to inflate it. They are infallible, madam. They're tried out by 20 of our umpty back inspectors on the Morden Edgeville Lane.
Well, it looks real, but I don't fancy it.
No, you, of course you do not fancy it, madam. Of course you do not. This is the Quasimodo model for men and boys. No, for the lady, we have something more delicate, Tom.
Ah, would you pardon me, madam? Would you open your jacket, please?
Now then. Once again, it's imagine you are on a crowded tube. You want to get a seat. Then all you have to do is to inflate this.
Twins? Triplets.
There. It is the infallible false pregnancy hump, madam. Now then. If, on the other hand, you...
Oh, hello, John.
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear,
have you had a bad day?
I had to stand all the way on the tube.
That is the end of that bit.
Water boy, where is your hiding? If you go.
In a relentless attempt to outpace the Western powers, Russian agents have invaded the Western entertainment field.
Ivan and his agents are currently trying to forge ahead of the Allies in the fields of jokes and comedy sketches. It is known that English and American comics have been kidnapped and interrogated. Will our lads talk? Not likely, Ivan.
Now look here, capitalist, imperialist comic. Listen here. We got here secret film of your performance in Grand Theater Film. Look.
Can I tell you stop mad dogs barking in Judah?
How do you stop mad dogs barking in Judah?
By shooting them in Judah.
Dear, oh dear, I don't wish to know that. Kindly leave this place. Now, ladies and gentlemen.
I say, tell me this. What is it that's got 8 wheels and flies?
I don't know what has got 8 wheels and flies.
Two corporation
dust carts. Are they NATO dust carts? I don't know. Why does King George V wear blue, white, and red braces?
To hold up his trap.
Dear, oh dear, I don't. What is real rank of King George V?
King George III. Oh,
take that. We could be friends because... Looking, why are they walking arm in arm?
Because they happen to be arms, I didn't.
Why are they walking arm in arm?
They got the end poof.
You understand?
No.
I take it.
We dance together.
Why did the chicken cross the road?
I get Mr. Watch that question.
Why did the chicken cross the road?
No, David, but you can't stop talking when I heard that.
Oh, the lady comrade was shot you with last night.
That was no lady, that was my wife.
Can a lady with a wooden leg change a pound note?
Yes!
You lie, she cannot!
Why?
only got half my kneecap.
I can't mix together, but you can't see that. You're not a bad sort of a chap, are you?
Here we see an English comic would sell his country for money. Cleverly disguised, he heaves a secret British answer joke inside a tree. It's not long before Russian agents are on the scene, heavily disguised. Ivan is not having it his own way. Oh no, British Secret Service comics are onto it and soon have another traitor in the bag. No, Ivan, you've got to be smarter than that if you want to twist the lion's tail.
Here we see some of the terrifying weapons being used in this silent war between the West and Russia.
That wiped the grin off Ivan's face.
Ow!
And that's a shocking handshake for the Ruskies. And that's one in the eye for Ivan, who's gone black with rage. And here's where Ivan's really slipped up. Wake up, Ivan! You're losing!
Morning, sir. Will you tell me what you think of this? Pim-pom-pop-a-pom.
It's like a bloody bomb to me.
Charming. Pim-pom-pop-a-pom.
It's female!
It's very erotic.
Because it's all high, nice.
But I'm not sure it's heavy enough, isn't it?
I am medically minded.
Pim-pom-pop-a-pom.
Lovely.
Why is it lovely?
It has got on the Irish aspect.
What does it remind you of?
Ah, a lot of things.
Lipping bum pa pa pum. Lipping bum pum pum pa pum pum. Pa pa pum.
Waterloo, Waterloo.
And take the
5:15 from Waterloo. Even smoker.
And 3 points to starboard.
The Duke will be there. He will be there. And Josephine, she won't be there. And, I won't be there.
Have they been? They've been round your way lately?
You're watching BBC TV, the station with a complete change of underwear. This week saw the start of the South London Unorthodox Amateur Athletics Association Sport Week. Here we see competitors from the Bromley Operatic Society in the 100 metres singing relay.
Fascinating rhythm, you've got me on the run. Each morning I get up with a howl.
So William blabs a clear win there by 8 bars in the key of E flat. Another exciting race was the 400 meters standing still race.
Here we are for the start of the 400 meters standing still dash. Inside lane is Grandy of Ireland, number 2 Thomas of Harry Harriers, 3 is Harrington of Cambridge, and 4 is Cambridge of Harrington. They're getting ready now, and they're off. It's Harrington, the inside lane, who's making the going. Grandy's pushing him, then Cambridge with Thomas as the back marker. Now they're all coming into the last 50 meters now, and it's still Harrington and Thomas, Cambridge and Grandy. It's neck and neck. They're neck and neck as they're about to come up to the tape. Hey, it looks like Thomas. No, it's Grandy.
I said, think it was a murder. No, Brandy Thomas. No, it's Brandy. It's Thomas. It's Brandy Thomas. No, I think it was Brandy, but it's a photo of second and third and fourth.
Here's an early football result. Arsenal, 3 managers. Tottenham, 2.
Here's a late newsflash. A millionaire living in Leeds has won the £5,000 premium bond prize. He said it will make no difference to his way of life. He will go on working as normal.
Today sees the finale of the annual Grandmother Hurling Contest at Beachy Head. The grandmothers and contestants are just warming up for the final throws. So over to Ivor Pocock.
Hello. It's a great day for the Grandmother Hurling Finals here at Beachy Head. In the last 3 eliminations, over 100 grandmothers were successfully thrown out to sea, out of which only 2 returned back in the penalty time of 1.5 minutes. Let's go over to last year's champion hurler and grandmother. Hello, this is Mr. John Squonk and his grandmother, Mrs. Ethel Squonk.
Good morning.
Could you tell us, how old are you?
5 feet 3.
And, what made you offer yourself for this hurling contest?
Well, I am a widow. My husband died. My cat died. But I didn't. So my gardener came and did this.
Yes, my word. We come down the end of good weather. I give us several good hurls off the cliff on the weekend. We have some great fun and the money comes in handy.
Hello, and this is Mr. Arthur Grinch and his 80-year-old grandmother.
Major, grandmother, and she's 91.
91? Well, 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 goodness me, 91 years of age, 91.
And the coroner said she was dead. But I got a second opinion, mine. And she looked all right, so I put her on. And she's 91, you see, and they go that way in the end.
Now, Major,
can't help it.
When they go, when you say they go that way, what?
91.
Because she's 91.
Yes, and a major, and the, well,
yourself, you are.
A major scamp from the middle.
Could you tell us this? Why are you? I think
she's going out there. She's a wind.
Yes. What I wanted to know, Major.
Put a ramp on her, Derek.
Yes.
Put a ramp on her.
Yes. Major, what?
Oh, we haven't got any blocks for the wheel.
Yes.
I'm telling you that you're 91.
I'd like to. 91. Yes. 91. Why are you using apparatus?
Oh, well, she's got these weak ankles, you see. And she's had more than a week, actually. I said 2 weeks.
Is this because of the straps that go around, the particular straps?
Because of the scrapsons on the blade.
We've got these hairy socks, and I don't like the handheld one.
And you prefer the traditional method?
No, I like the hurl method. Hurl out to sea.
Yes.
She's left me money in the will, and there's the cottage.
I see.
And
this is...
Tell us you're having right to.
Yes. I see. So I think we're ready. That sounds...
She's 91 and ready.
And 91. So I think we're ready for the first scrampsons on the... for the first hurl. The Major is just making sure that the straps are...
Granny.
Yes.
And clench your teeth. Here go, pop.
She's clenching her teeth now. And
flatten out.
He has instructed her. He's instructed her now to flatten out over the rocks when she's about to go. Now.
I'm ready.
I think he's ready now. Looking at his watch, he's. Major, that really was quite wonderful. I'd like to congratulate you. It was a wonderful hurl. A wonderful
hurl. Good for her.
And now John Squonk, OBE, with his traditional freestyle hurl.
Now don't worry, darling. The rocks will break your fall.
He's ready now. He wheels around once, twice. He's building up into a power build-up into ever-increasing circles and... That was a beauty. It certainly could be a close thing.
Here in Scotland, we have a very difficult political problem.
Oh, him, you Cessna!
Oh, there, oh, there.
Yes, the colour problem in England. The cost of colour television is prohibitive. It is also beyond the pocket of the ordinary viewer, like Tom Scroke of Leeds, who says... We have therefore decided to give you a form of colour television for those of you who have only black and white sets.
Yes?
Good morning, with the blue skies and grey tinges in the east. I'm Inspector McShagnasty.
Inspector McShagnasty?
Hey.
Haven't you a ruddy complexion and deep, penetrating blue eyes?
Aye, and you must be Madame Fanny Grope with the purple rinse with the silver streaks over the creamy ears.
Yes, and it contrasts vividly with my spotty pink complexion.
Aye, may I speak to your husband in the front room where the red glow of the fire will reflect upon his yellow jowls?
Of course, do come in late.
Thank you, in magenta.
Oh, may I draw your attention to the lemon and green hall carpet?
And by Jove, look here, you have a blue wall with a silver Georgian stripe in it.
Yes, come in.
Oh, who is this man with the dark green tie and the fawn raincoat?
I'm Inspector McShagnasty, and I arrest you, your brown trousers, and your tartan slippers with a spot of orange marmalade on the toe for robbery.
Me? A robbery? With a spot of orange marmalade on my slippers? I swear by my uncle's orange, grey and black blazer that it is a white lie.
Then why has your face gone a ruddy glow, giving you purple veins around your proboscis? No, sir. Hold out those off-white arms with the blue hairs while I put on these bronzed handcuffs.
To prevent holding up the show for normal commercials, we will now include them in the sketch.
You never take me alive. I would sooner jump out of this £2.09 all-aluminium non-corrosive window.
Stop or I'll shoot you with a Smith & Wesson 45 pistol, price £3.10 in all gunsmiths, bullets extra.
You never take me or my double support jockey underpants alive.
Stop or I'll...
Ah!
Oh! 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 You've made a hole in his white nylon drip-dry Revlon shirt.
I told you, wouldn't
you? 18 and 6, a bargain.
And the blood.
Oh!
The blood, it is red. And staining the Cyril Lord.
Darling, it will soon come out with cracker. The washing powder with the D built inside, 6 pence a packet at all supermarkets.
Oh. Get some today.
Oh, he's dead.
No, not. The bullet was deflected by my Hadworth's all-steel butane cigarette lighter. Price? 5 shillings, built to last.
I must warn you, sir, that I happen to know that they come in 3 distinct colors. Green, grey, and glitter gold for the ladies. It's the cigarette lighter that fools Scotland Yard.
Get Hadworth's.
You know it makes sense.
Good evening. It's been a muggy sort of a day with the scampons on. The general picture is that there are a lot of these black lines moving across the country over towards Northern Ireland. Should be gone by tomorrow morning. There also appears what would appear to be a Russian tank attack developing. As you can see here and here, the number of coloured people living in these areas. And also, those people living in the Thames estuary will find a large blackboard of about 100 miles long running out to sea with the letters about mile high, rain. And noon tomorrow will be just south of Iceland. So let's see what sort of weather we're going to have tonight, shall we? Please be all right. So I'll say good night and...
You'll be watching Q5, the programme without Julie Andrews or David Frost. Ginger Rogers is now appearing in a £5,000 a week dressing room at Drury Lane. Isn't she, dear? Yes.
You may remember earlier in the programme a lady wrote in saying that her husband had died suddenly after being run over by a steamroller. She is now offering for sale a rather unique bookmarker. Good night.